Which Scandinavian is the best at lying? Elite best liar. Which Scandinavian? Sweden is represented by you, Teo.
Teo, yeah, I'm a Swedish YouTuber and streamer.
Yes.
And we're here with Jonas, the Minecraft YouTuber.
Yeah, the less prominent Norwegian average dude. And I will represent the Norwegians in a fine manner.
Wow, okay. You're taking this very seriously.
Yeah. 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 It is a competition.
Yeah, no,
and I don't take. I got a stroke. And I don't take any competition not seriously.
Okay. Okay. I thought my abs were caused by me rubbing my stomach.
What? How old were you when you thought this?
Ooh, maybe 14?
Yes, okay.
Yeah. As a kid, when you're skinny, you often have not abs, but you might think you have abs then. Your muscles show because you have no body fat.
Yeah.
And I thought it was because I thought you could kind of get them even bigger as well by rubbing your stomach. Mm. I don't know why I thought this.
You didn't have physical education at all at school?
Apparently not. Well, I, looking back at it, it's really embarrassing because, you know, it's just awful. Like, why would a kid think that? And I was embarrassingly old to think rubbing my abs would cause them to somehow grow.
It's super weird.
It is super weird. And I actually, so the embarrassing part about it is that the rubbing would be like this.
Okay, so would you bruise yourself?
A little bit. I'd get red. Perhaps not bruises.
Well.
Rubbing doesn't really, yeah. I'd get red.
Yeah.
And I did it in class.
Not you did this in class?
Yeah.
Might look like something else.
And I did it, and the teacher thought we were making fun of her.
What are you doing? You were saying, I'm rubbing myself. And she said, don't do that in class.
Looking back, I really hope I didn't say that. She was a lovely teacher.
How long period of time did you rub your belly to get ripped?
It was probably a few weeks, maybe a couple months, that it was like a highlight of my life.
No disrespect if this is true, but this is too stupid for me. Like, I think it's a lie.
Okay. Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's true. Yes!
Oh my God.
I was a bit of a cringy child.
I bet you saw those TV shop ads with the electrical ones.
It must have been something.
Oh my God,
I think
that must
so.
Be the perfect
it was around the time that was on TV.
I should ask about that. Oh, well, good job. Sip of water from the brain, for the brain, not from the brain. Don't drink water from your brain. Keep the water in the brain and stay healthy. Stay healthy, everybody.
What's that reaction?
It's dumb.
Okay.
This is dumb.
Yeah, are you buying time here?
Once as a child, I believed that the devil possessed my computer. And that's it. That's the thing.
Okay, your computer.
Yeah.
So, around what age? What was this?
Was around like 9, 10, maybe. Mm-hmm. It was on a family computer.
Okay.
The reason I thought this was that I was going to play The Sims 2, I think it mm-hmm. was at the moment. And my brother had helped me install it, and it was ready for me like a couple of days after he installed it. And I was opening the game, and there was a family already in the game. With the last name 666.
Okay.
And there was one family member in this family, and that was Satan. And I had a pretty like light but still religious upbringing. Mm-hmm. I were like, what would you call it? Like culturally more than anything, Christians.
So you were a bit aware of...
Yeah, and as a child, I was very into God, and I was, like, praying a lot. Every time I would get in the car, I would be like, dear God, please don't let us crash. And Mom would be like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And I'm just praying to God, so don't crash.
Okay.
So I was, like, sort of a Christian child.
Yeah.
And
that led to you straight up believed that the devil was in your, had possessed your computer.
I got really, really scared and went running, crying to mommy.
Yeah.
And I was like superstitious, like really superstitious. So I thought like there was some devil shit going on.
I think that it's, God, this one's tough.
Now I'll just frozen my face so you cannot read my face anymore.
Oh, I think that it's, it's the truth.
It is the truth.
Yes! Yes! Oh, great. Oh, that one was really hard, actually.
I was preparing my body for a celebration.
Oh, I'm really happy about that. That one was good.
That was a good prank. I sort of wish like
the
I
devil
was
possessed your. Yeah. I'm so sorry. Yeah. For a few years, I never looked in the mirror in the bathroom.
Oh. What, were you scared?
Yes.
Oh, so sort of like ghost story. I won't give it to you. Why were you scared of looking in the mirror?
Well, it's kind of a ghost story, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, not a ghost. I was quite superstitious. I had a lot of worries. I watched a movie with my friend.
Yeah.
About Bloody Mary.
Oh yeah.
The whole Bloody Mary urban legend is that you can't say her name three times in front of the mirror. So I, for a few years, when I went into the bathroom, I never looked at the mirror.
But you could just look in the mirror and not say Bloody Mary three times.
I could, but that wasn't enough for me. I was scared that she'd pop up, so I didn't look at the mirror. For a few years.
How old were you?
I would say I was, this started maybe when I was 11 or 12 and probably ended when I was 13, 14, something like that. Yeah, so it was 2-3 years.
Every evening you were like standing in the corner facing the wall brushing your teeth?
No. Just like the ring girl or whatever.
Because you had to do it over the sink, so you're like doing it like this.
Yeah, like that. I wasn't in the corner though. That's a bit too much. No, I would just not look. I would come in, and I would take my toothbrush, and I'd put toothpaste, and I'd brush my teeth, and I just would never look at the mirror.
What about other mirrors?
That's fine.
Okay, it's the bathroom mirror.
The bathroom mirror.
Bloody Mary is the bathroom story.
I don't know. For me, something about being in the bathroom, I didn't look at the mirror for a few years.
One more question.
Got it. Hit
what me. Gave you the courage to look in the mirror again? That must be an empowering story to hear.
I think I started realizing how ridiculous it was.
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah.
And I decided to face my fears and look in the mirror.
You know what? I'm going to say that it's true.
You're gonna go with true.
Well, I don't feel I can change it after that outburst.
Tell me what you think it is.
I'll go with true.
Yeah, it's true.
It is!
Yeah.
Oh my god, you almost changed my mind.
I was really trying to change your mind.
Oh wow, that was powerful stuff. Wow. I once got kicked out of a club because of Viggo Mortensen. Like, do you know Viggo Mortensen?
Yeah.
Viggo Mortensen. Aragorn.
Thank you. My god. Clearly I'm not on it.
He was my god at some point. I really adored him.
Was your god?
Yeah.
So you loved Viggo Mortensen?
Yeah.
And why don't you love him anymore?
I try to separate artist and art, so I sort of love him still. But it was a very awkward situation.
This is a very strange story. So you love Viggo Mortensen and you got kicked out of a club.
Because of him, yeah.
Go on, then why did you get kicked out because of Viggo? What happened?
The thing is, I like to travel with my girlfriend.
Here we go.
We travel to Copenhagen.
Okay, yeah.
And he has relatives in Denmark still. Like
Viggo does?
Yeah, he's part...
How do you know this?
He's part Danish.
Okay.
And I'm
he has them in Copenhagen.
Yeah, I'm very keen on like
Viggo Mortensen's brothers and sisters and where they live.
In general, heritage of Hollywood stars. Like
if this is true, it's
Brie
very
Larson,
funny.
For example,
yeah,
she has a Norwegian heritage, and I
got
feel
it.
That's cool for me to know because I'm a fan of Norway, you know, and Scandinavian in general.
Yeah,
like Stellan Skarsgård, I love him.
Yeah, but his okay.
He's
go
Swedish.
On. Yeah, go on.
I've been a fan of like Viggo's work, first name basis, you know. for a long time, ever since Lord of the Rings and the Green Book and all that stuff. So
got
great.
It. Well, tell me a lesser-known movie of Viggo Mortensen.
A lesser-known movie?
Yeah, what's your favorite
I feel
kind
the
of
road,
indie by him?
Everyone's
I know
sort
about
of forgotten The
yeah,
Road.
But something even lesser-known. As a fan, you must know his whole filmography, you know.
Yeah, but like it's mostly Lord of the Rings. I'm a big Lord of the Rings fan.
You're a bit of a fake.
Yeah, one could say that.
More of an Aragorn.
I'm a fan of Viggo Mortensen, and I love great, epic movies.
Got it. So yeah. You can't name me any kind of any movie I won't
it's
know.
Hard to do on the spot.
Yeah,
History
of
Violence.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
A, you know that one as well?
Yeah. Yeah,
yeah, but then
have you seen
know.
It?
Yes, I think
I happen to
it.
Be a Viggo Mortensen. I'm interrogating you.
Oh, yeah, okay. Because I think
right,
History of
yeah.
Violence, you know, sometimes I like watch a movie quite passively while I do
yeah.
like.
And what was the
like Cookie Clicker or some dumb shit on my computer.
So you watched it on the side.
Yeah.
Just in case I ask you about something about the movie that you won't remember.
No, it's about violence, though.
Yeah.
Isn't like it's sort of like a family drama, thriller.
Yeah.
Is
yeah.
that true? I'm not sure about
and
that.
And one final question. Yeah. Just before we get into the clubs, I've given you enough time to think of a story.
Yeah.
That movie he did where he's got like 4 or 5 kids.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, as a
yeah,
big Viggo
yeah.
fan, you must know
yeah,
that. What's the name
well,
of that?
I don't remember, but I've
no,
seen that one.
No,
because
okay.
he moves out, in th- because the mother's
yeah,
dead, and
yeah.
he moves out into the forest
yeah,
with a bunch of kids.
You don't want to spoil the movie here, but
no,
yeah.
No, but
yeah.
it's like...
cool, yeah, but you don't
but
remember
that's
what it's
not
called.
Like,
yeah.
That's not a
got it.
Good Viggo Mortensen
got
movie.
It, got it. Anyway, so you're at the club. Let's move forward.
Yeah. Me and my girlfriend, we were in Copenhagen, and we went to one of the, like the nicer clubs there. And I don't remember the name because I was very drunk, and that's the big part of the story.
Mm-hmm.
We go into the club, and Viggo Mortensen is there.
Really?
And my girlfriend,
you must have been mind blown as thinking that he's your god.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, maybe God was an exaggeration.
Well, that's what you said.
I was like playing on things you said.
Yeah,
like,
of
yeah,
course.
I did
yeah.
really. I'm a big, big Viggo Mortensen
so
fan.
So you went up
or
and
Aragorn
you
fan.
Screamed. Right?
No, I didn't. I'm quite reserved. I feel like I want to respect his space and stuff like that.
Got it.
But as alcohol is consumed further, I at some point get the courage to go up to him, also helped by my girlfriend. She's like, you have to go and take a picture with him at least. And he's sitting in the bar with his friends, which is a really awkward situation. And I go up there and I'm like asking to take a picture with him. And he refuses because he's with his friends, which normally I would respect. And like that's why this is so painful, because I was like...
This must be a really painful story
yeah,
for
yeah,
you to
yeah,
retell,
yeah.
this memory.
So I was like, come on, come on.
Yeah. yeah.
And he just like gave a guard
looked
one look,
bodyguard.
And he was like,
yeah.
sorry. No, no, like the people that work there
got it,
at the
yeah.
club. And they were like, oh, we don't want that for Viggo here.
Yeah. How long ago was this?
It's like 5 years ago.
5 years ago.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. It's painful.
Yeah, this isn't true.
That's correct. It's not true. It was really difficult.
No, you did a really good job at trying to. It was so funny to me trying to get you to talk about his movies.
I feel like that's like
you know
watching someone trying to row a boat that's tied to the to
yeah,
the
you were really yeah. trying. And you know, I think where you made the mistake was starting it off by going, Viggo's a god to me.
I ate a snail off the ground.
Oh, God. Why?
Oh, my God! Yes! Oh.
I have 9 toes.
God damn it!
Oh! I tried really hard to give it some backstory.
Yeah, but it was really, really good.
Yeah.